The views and comments expressed on the following radio program by its hosts and their guests do not necessarily reflect the views of RMCOnAir.com or its affiliates. Listener discretion is advised.
Are we on the motherfucking air?
What?
Hold on, let me put this little pussy-ass earpiece in. Ladies and gentlemen, it's the bootleg 5150.
Better hide this look. Mm.
The late night 5150.
And straight no chaser.
God damn it, I ain't holding back shit, this motherfucker.
That's it.
I am Corey Hogan, sitting next to
Darlene Ortiz, and I need to put my sweater on.
Yeah, she got that. You so
I swear.
Phony. Oh my God.
Corey.
And Bobby is here also.
Back in the stride again.
Darlene got her motherfucking rack out trying to act like she ain't do it on purpose.
No,
shit.
I didn't know that it was see through, so that's the thing. I'm not.
Right. Yeah, Darlene, you didn't know.
Yeah, I swear, because it's bright in here. Anyway.
That's some bullshit right there.
Whatever.
Your shit was see-through on that one. Most of your game is tight, but that one was see-through. I didn't know.
No, I really didn't. Earlier, it's totally different lighting. I didn't know. We get in here and look. It's like,
that's what's up.
It's hitting me from the top. And it's
All right.
Anyway, wow. So Corey was here finally on time.
Give
actually,
a fuck.
Actually ahead of time, but then we had internet connection problems, so it wasn't Corey.
It was the pussy's bootleg station. Set up in the back of a restaurant.
Look at that telephone. That's right, little bastard.
a wing stop with a radio station in this motherfucker.
A wing stop.
There's some lemon pepper radio in this bitch.
They did look good though. Look, it's funny you said that because that lady at the desk was eating some.
Oh, yeah, lousy bitch. Anyway, what's up? You got the loose talk about bullshit?
I do, but you didn't tell me if you wanted to talk about anything.
Well, I hope it's some good shit.
You know,
listeners,
to me.
If it's some bullshit, please let it be known. Somebody needs to. The shit you type in is red. So if Darlene loose talk about bullshit is not appetizing, let it be known. So let's hit some juicy shit.
All right. Well. As you know, Ocho Cinco is now a free man.
It's bullshit out of here.
Here we go. No, I dig this, though, because I hate to go there because I don't know or anything, but I think that certain people do set up certain things to make it, get him some pub. In other words, put it like this. So Ocho Cinco was photographed, and it was out there. It's like one of those cafes on Sunset Plaza, right, where a lot of stars go and they eat and they get photographed. Mm-hmm. But this one, they knew the girl was pulling up. Parked. I'm going to say her name right now because I know of her. I don't know her.
Please put the bitch out.
Hold on, though. I think that somebody called and set this up because he's looking like, what in the hell? Like, these people are taking our photo. But she's kind of like, she looks okay with it, walking from their car to even meeting him. There's a bunch of different photos. But anyway, everybody was speculating that, wow, look, Ocho Cinco is 2 weeks out of his divorce and now he's already dating somebody. But...
Said he was already dating the bitch when he was married.
Goddamn
it! Just, now he ain't got to hide the bitch no more.
Okay, well here's the funny deal though. They put this on there.
The deal though.
Oh my God! You see where Bobby's mind is?
It's late night.
He said it's late. Actually. Okay, I Go said ahead. The deal though. Anyway, she's not saying anything. His camp is saying no. This is his life coach. You ever heard some
what
such
is that?
Malarkey? Yeah, thank you. What is that? Is that somebody that's... Anyway, because I don't think that they like that. He's 34 and she's 49. And it's homegirl from... She's an actress. AJ Johnson?
No, he didn't.
Yeah, and they're out. But she looks like she's kind of happy about it. Like, they're taking photos of her
walking. No shit, that bitch ain't got nothing going for.
She's out. Yeah, I think like the last movie she was
in. Is that
the
bitch you played in Baby Boy?
Thank you, yes.
That bitch be walking this big ass dog around my house. She got a Great Dane.
Oh, she lives out there. A what?
Yeah, I guess dude ran out of money she was living with, so now she's trying to.
Oh my God, she wants you to take her in, Corey?
No, hell no. She ain't gonna fuck with me. I ain't got no paper for her like that.
Well, anyway, that was interesting because now they're saying no. His reps deny it, and they're saying that that's actually his life coach.
That's a good game. They look alike. They'll make a baby that looks just like
a
little gangbanger aunt.
Anyway, that was interesting to me, but I brought that story up just to say that I really think that it was kind of set up, but not on his part. I think hers, for some reason, she seemed cool with it.
She needs the press.
Maybe. I don't know. I'm just...
Has she done anything since Baby Boy?
I don't think so. No, wait. What was that other one? House Party. Oh, that came after or before?
That was a long time ago.
No, I know, but I'm making fun. I'm saying, was that after or before Baby Boy?
She perpetrate the young face in House Party. She got that wisdom look now.
Anyway, so that was interesting to me. But now here, oh my God.
She got Diane Reeves on her iPod.
Here we go with this thing. I know you've heard of the Hulk Hogan sex tape, right?
No.
Oh, stop it. Please tell me.
Get the fuck out of here.
Are you serious?
Hulk Hogan is...
You haven't heard? Okay, so the sex tape came
out. Well, that paper get low, boy. No.
Oh, here we go. Here we go. All right, so almost like 2 months ago it came out, right?
Okay.
It was all over, you know, certain media outlets. Now, they were saying that he is saying he had nothing to do with it. He didn't leak it. This is what they're claiming. He's claiming, anyway, that he's upset that it was leaked, right? He said, I'm going to find out who leaked this, because in the video, the girl is giving him oral sex and his cell phone rings and he answers it. He said, I think this is my son. Hold on. And so he answers his cell phone. And then she tries to continue, and I think that there's some kind of problems, because then he stops her again. He goes, ugh. And then he kind of rubs his belly, and he's like, you know what? I shouldn't have ate so much.
Oh, what, his dick wouldn't get hard?
I don't know. They never said, but
I know he was fucking a bitch on a bed from Rent-A-Center. You can bet that shit.
Wait, here we go. It gets deeper. We find out who leaked it, and we find out who the girl was, too, that was in the thing. So that was a couple of months ago when they said that there was a sex tape that existed, and all these people were talking about that had seen it. We're commenting. Okay, so now here we go. Just the other day, here it comes out. And you know that Linda Hogan, bless her heart, do you know that Linda Hogan, his ex-wife, was just released Thursday, this past Thursday, on a DUI in Malibu?
She looked like an old drunk bitch.
And they, anyway, that said, because they said that it had nothing to do with him, you know, his embarrassment with this tape. But here we go. So they find out who leaked the tape. And guess what? It'd be like Bobby filming you secretively and leaking a tape.
Is he gonna film me?
It was his best friend.
Hulk Hogan's best friend?
Yeah. So Hulk Hogan finally found out that his best friend, Bubba, was the one that leaked his sex tape and is now suing him. Bubba, hold on now.
Wait. Hold on, darling.
There's more. Hold on, Corey.
His
wait till you get this.
His best friend, Bubba.
Wait. I'm not done. Let me finish, and then you're going to watch. I'm gonna take you there. Watch. So Bubba secretly taped the Hulk having sex with his own wife, Heather. Do you get where I'm going?
Yeah, I'm saying, like, Bubba, how do you secretly get taped by a man?
No, he taped him, but he didn't know that he was going to be released. In other words, they're all freaky. This is his best friend's wife. This guy, Bubba, was the camera holder. And his wife was having sex with Hulk, and they're all friends.
That's
his wife.
Yes.
Bubba's wife was having sex with Hulk Hogan.
Yes.
Let me tell you something. If two people are fucking and they tape each other, there's a chance that it can be some "this is between us" shit. But when there is actually another person
you
in
don't
the
have
room
any,
taping,
yeah, hello, what are you thinking?
The shit is going to go out.
Yes. Uh-huh.
The production is not for nothing.
And do you know what they said that they heard at the end of the tape when, like, Hulk is out of the picture and the guy has got the camera? He goes, man, he was like, hey, if we ever come short of some money. Like, really? What are you trying to say, dude? That thing wouldn't sell. Do you mean you're going to sell it to the media? But they heard.
People will watch Hulk Hogan fuck?
Oh, are you? Dude, I am at the thought.
Come here, bitch. Get on this dick right now. Hulk's about to skeet up your ass.
Have you ever seen him without the bandana?
No.
Oh, that alone is just scaring me.
What?
Without the bandana. You've never seen him with it. Because, you know, it stops right here. It looks like this hair is glued all the way across. So this is all missing.
Oh. Oh, he has no hair up top.
I almost think that blonde hair that's hanging down is attached to the bandana.
Oh, yeah.
Like one of those Halloween
But he's still the Hulkster. There are people out here who've been watching him for years.
Would you, Corey, honestly?
And would love to see him perform.
Would you? You'd watch.
You're playing dumb. You would watch the Hulk fuck somebody.
But I'd be grossed out. I think I'd be like this.
You'll watch it while you're grossed out, though. That's the bullshit. When you watch porn with girls, it's the worst shit in the world. Hey, what is he doing? The same thing I did to you, bitch. How can you talk about what he's doing?
No, I'm not going to lie. I am somewhat curious, but I'm not like, ugh.
It's just like when the R. Kelly shit was out. People wanted to watch the shit to see what the fuck, what it was.
Sure, that's our
what that nigga
though.
Working with, talking all that shit. Pied Piper my ass.
Woo.
You harmonica piper, motherfucker.
So you analyzed it, huh?
Boy. I'm just saying.
So out of all the sex tapes that were of celebrities, did you actually
I've
like
never
any?
Watched a sex tape. The R. Kelly tape was on because I wanted to see him piss on a little bitch.
And did you see it?
Yeah, I saw him piss on the bitch.
So back in the day, did you ever see the Jane Kennedy one?
Well, he was putting his fist in a pussy and all that shit. Mm-hmm. You know, I never seen it, but I heard about it.
I wonder, he could probably still get it, huh?
Once a girl start getting into that fist and shit, she is useless to anybody but a fist.
Yeah, but have you ever met her? That's a big lady. That's a big girl.
That bitch got to meet that new movie dude, Wreck-It Ralph.
Beautiful face.
Let Wreck-It Ralph finger.
You know what?
Fist you, bitch.
Stop.
Wreck-It
anyway.
Ralph, come here. This bitch, I don't
she's
like
beautiful.
Fingers. She like hands. She like to get fisted.
Callers, if you want to call in, the number is 323-965. 1600-1600.
Fisting motherfuckers. Tell the truth. You ever been fisted?
Oh my God. How are you going to be, Corey? Really?
I'm asking you why you didn't just say yes or no. You're like, oh my God.
By what? Like a little midget? I mean, come on. You know what? A real man. Come on. Make a fist, Corey.
If a woman has a child, you had a child. That means.
Yeah, but I had it sewn even tighter. When you have an episiotomy, I had him. You can add some.
Wait. Now this is some late breaking news right here. Darlene and had her pussy put back together.
No, but everybody can do that, Corey. You don't know. You were probably never in there for any of your births. So, but anyway,
I didn't know about the shit.
You didn't know what they were having a baby without you knowing.
I didn't believe that shit.
You didn't show up for any of your births of your kids.
Hell no. Nah.
Anyway, look, we got a caller.
Back
on the
when
line.
I used to hoop.
Whatever. Let's take a call. Caller.
What's good? It's OG from Texas.
What's up, OG?
What's going on? Hey, look, just basically on the situation y'all talking about, Bubba Clem, or a.k.a. Bubba the Love Sponge, this motherfucker, all this shit is a scandal, it's a setup. You heard him back on, well, anybody who listened to the Howard Stern show back in the day when he was actually on their channels,
mm-hmm.
he always gave permission for Howard Stern and also for Hulk Hogan, which is Terry, to fuck his wife, Heather.
The same woman? Dang, they're nasty, huh?
Exactly. So, and if you know anything about Bubba the Love Sponge, he keeps cameras everywhere, even on his show, keeping cameras everywhere. All the shit was a setup. But let's move on to the OG bus driver who uppercut the shit that all you
yeah.
get.
That's what the fuck we was going to talk
that's
about
right.
today.
You brought it up because we were going to talk about
I want to hear what you have to say, but let me put some people up to speed because some people don't know. In Cleveland, Ohio, an irrational, crazy bitch got into an argument with a bus driver who became the victim of handling his business with the bitch.
my God.
They was talking about each other. This is for everybody who don't know about the video. They were talking about each other. You know, back and forth. And he said something about some scratches on the bitch face. And that made her mad because everybody was laughing. So she hauled off and hit him and spit on him. And
wow.
he got up and he was like, oh, you going to jail? But he couldn't resist that jaw. That jaw was right there.
Didn't he seem like he'd been practicing that? Like he probably never really used it?
He ain't had no power in his punch, but his accuracy was on point.
I don't know. It looked pretty powerful, Corey.
No, was just the sound of the teeth and the tongue.
But she still lifted up. Didn't she raise? Did she?
Yeah, it's a girl. So he was able to raise up, but that bitch got a jaw.
It looked like she left the ground a little
anyway,
bit.
Anyway, the bus driver punched the bitch on some motherfucking Ken from Street Fighter shit. That type of uppercut. Oh, okay. If anybody who know about Street Fighter, that's how he caught the bitch. But the bitch didn't fall, so he threw the bitch off the bus. And after he hit the bitch that had hit him, people became concerned because when you hit bitches back, they think you wrong. Let's talk about that. What was your opinion on that, sir?
I'm going to say, look, just like the man said at the end of the tape when people was questioning him about the shit, if you want to act like a man, you're going to get treated like a man.
Boom.
She had no business putting her hands on that bus driver, nor then the relentless spitting. You spit in my
mouth. Ooh, that's, face. Yeah. Isn't that illegal? That's illegal some places.
Yeah,
I thought that was.
No, it's not some places. In America, it's an assault.
Okay, there you go, see?
They're charged with assault when you spit on somebody.
Wow. And where are you from, sir?
Texas.
Caller? Oh, is that what he said, Texas?
Yeah.
Hmm.
Well, what are you still
Cleveland.
On?
Cleveland. I don't say Cleveland already. Come
when
on.
When people
now.
Call in, I want to ask them what advice would they give to. You can pick anybody on the bus driver. What advice would you give to the girl? What advice would you give to the people in the back, especially the girls on the bus? Because nobody says this. The girls on the bus, you hear them laughing and giggling. And even when she hit the bus driver, you heard them laughing. But when they saw that bitch get uppercut, they was like, oh, my God, that's a girl. You ain't you stupid bitch. You going to get it too if you don't shut the fuck up.
What is this? I love this.
That's how the bitches was. I mean, you couldn't see them, but you know normally right. When bitches see some
no, but you know what? Wait. The one that I saw... You actually see some people. There's like a big white kid, and he's turning. He's like laughing, like, oh, my God, you see this? He's enjoying it. Did you see that part? He's got glasses on. He's tall. He's like this, oh, shoot. It looked like he enjoyed it. Like, we're at the UFC.
Yeah.
He turned around, and he's laughing. You see his face.
The reason I thought it was funny was because of the way the girl conducted herself. If
right.
You conduct yourself that way, I really feel like you deserve what you get.
But how about also taking it to the next level and talking about it in the press, and you're making it sound totally different.
We're going to get into that because
okay. All
the people who don't know, this bitch lawyers have some bullshit going on. We're going to talk about that.
Okay.
But don't we got a caller now? I want to see what he has to say about what we said so far.
Go ahead, caller.
This is Soul One. We're talking to y'all earlier. What's
hey.
Going on, people?
What's up?
Hey. Damn late for black people time, boy. I swear, man. Ooh, I could not wait to y'all start talking. Cause I was just about to make that point. That's not the funny news. The interview by the news people of this chick.
Mm.
That was the real. That was the even funnier part because she sit there, play that role. Oh, I put his hand in it. But the reporter asked her. What about your part? Oh, I can't discuss because my lawyer's not like, get the fuck out of here.
See, you're right. I caught that too.
I had to show this that field to my daughter. They were fighting. I told them, look, this is what happens when you put your hands on people. Don't assume because you're a man that a man ain't going to do anything. Did he go too far? Perhaps.
When?
Perhaps.
When did he go too far?
Right. Bobby is of the opinion he didn't go far enough.
OG Bobby Johnson, what's going on? I'm glad I came from you.
Man, you're going to start a rumor, man. I got enough people can't even pronounce my name right.
That's it. Bobby 10-minute
Lanton.
Bobby 10-minute.
10 minutes. That's all I need. 10 minutes. That's all I need.
Right.
No,
my
well,
wrist.
I personally don't condone hitting on a person, but there's a lot of cases where I understand.
All right, I got to hold it. Hold up, bro, right there. When you say condone, in other words, do you mean that if somebody come up and whoop you till you catch on fire, you're going to just give them permission to do that? I mean, when do you start defending yourself?
I'm not going to never give nobody permission to hit on me. Now, you're talking to a man who I was married before, and I was a baddest man. I'm not afraid to say that. But it took me being a man to walk away.
Because
I know if I'd have hit my first wife, I'd have killed that bitch. But like I said, I understand.
I just want all the ladies out there to know that there is no never hit a woman rule. That is insane. If you walk in the house and, you know, your new wife that you marry and your son ain't by her and she got her tongue in his ass and he 8 years old, you're going to stomp the bitch brains out.
You know what? In that case, Corey... Yeah, I'm about to go on and split up.
You see what I'm saying? I got scenarios where you're going to beat the shit out of bitch.
And you know how
beat
I feel.
Beat the shit out of bitch scenarios right there.
Right there. Beat the bitch out of bitch.
I'm just going to headbutt her, you know, to her skull split like Ocho. That's what I'm
right.
going to do.
Well, you know.
Well,
when I get hauled into jail, I want the police to be asking me questions like, why the fuck did you keep hitting the bitch? I don't want that one little crack in the head. I want that head to be permanently damaged. So no matter what, whoever with you, I'm going to be like you with that split wig head, bitch.
You know what?
I'm just keeping it real.
But you know how I feel about this because is this the same caller that just said that you were battered?
Yeah.
Yes,
okay,
I was.
My mother used to do that to my dad. So
right.
My dad would do all he could to just get away. And she's just barraged, just hitting
question.
Him with stuff. Yeah.
How tall was your dad?
They were the same height.
Okay, that don't tell me.
5'8". Both were 5'8". Yeah, what does that have to do with anything? No, he was a good dude. I witnessed all this, Corey. I'm just saying, she instigated everything. Anytime somebody is just socking on you and your kids are looking and you're just trying not to, you know what I'm saying? You got to walk away, like he said.
Men under 5'10 have been tried physically by their woman.
But I can see it coming. You're right, though, Carl. I could see it coming, boiling in his, like, if I stay any longer.
Caller, how tall are you?
He's going to go there.
I'm 5'9" and a half.
Yeah, she came at you.
And he got a nice voice.
All guys under 5'10", they woman run up and try to fight them.
That's silly.
The truth.
Corey, you can expand that a little more, though, because as I am 6'2", and I'm big as I ever been now.
Bobby, I didn't even know that.
When I was about 160, you know, they sized me up like, well, I think I can run through him. You know, and I'm like, nah, I really think you understand. Well, you don't understand that I would bite the shit out of your ass.
You know what?
You see, I wouldn't give a damn if you're a 200-pound bitch.
I'm not against biting the bitch.
Yeah, I'm scared because that other week, that first week y'all were on, I saw Bobby eating something, and I'm scared of them. I'm scared of them biting.
I ain't battled but a couple of times, but it ain't been no return engagement.
I'm just playing, Bobby.
Go ahead, caller.
Moral of the story is you keep your head daggone hands to yourself.
You never know. Yep, don't push buttons. Don't test anybody.
Sit on people. You're liable to get uppercut. The greatest uppercut since Mike Tyson and Leon Spinks.
Wow.
Right. He caught that bitch jaw. And Yeah, he caught that motherfucker perfectly. Made the perfect sound effects and all that shit.
Almost didn't look real.
Let's get a moment of silence for the bitch Joe right now. give me 10 seconds of silence, please. 10 seconds, please.
Okay,
go.
Please.
10 seconds, 10. Go.
1, 2. Wakaya! Oh, you get...
Okay, that was for the bitch Joe. If you're listening, bitch, we want to fly you to L.A. and take you to the soup plantation. Because...
That's our diet.
Right, bitch. You're going to lose some more weight after
Corey,
that.
But, Corey, isn't there more that you want to share?
Thanks, Carla.
Thanks, Carla. Is there more that you want to share with us, Corey?
This is what I want everybody to know.
Yeah.
Corey Holcomb does research to try to better the 5150 show. So I found the bitch Twitter who got super socked. And I reached out to the bitch. And when I sent this bitch to Twitter, this is all that Illuminati shit that motherfucker be talking about. Let me tell you some real shit that went on. At first, I made a joke. I was like, to all my Twitter people, I'm about to invite the bitch to L.A. Try to get my dick sucked because I know she ain't biting shit. That's the first joke I said.
She had a broke joke.
Right. She ain't biting shit, goddamn it. If she tried to bite it, it'd probably feel good. her jaw muscle ain't healed yet. I don't give a fuck. Even though she ain't get knocked out, that jaw, when she calmed down and felt that jaw. But anyway, this is what happened. So as I tried to reach out to the bitch, my Twitter started tripping. Because the bitch, I saw the bitch, her Twitter went from about a couple of hundred to all of a sudden she had like 2,000 followers. And when I tried to reach out to her on Twitter, Twitter said, right now, Twitter is over capacity and all that bullshit with the goof-ass whale smiling at your ass. People on Twitter know what I'm talking about. Yeah. And my shit didn't act right for a whole day and a half.
That's scary.
So when my Twitter did act right again, I looked up, the bitch has 6,000-something followers. And a new picture on there.
Oh, stop it.
Where she had, because the first picture, the bitch looked like, old bitch, Leon you go Spinks. Visit in the projects and wash up in a sink.
The next picture,
they had the bitch, like she had went to Ross Dress for Less and bought her a little outfit or something. Where she was smiling and trying to look cute. I was like, wow, this bitch, they switched this bitch Twitter up and everything.
Wow.
So when I went to the Twitter today, her Twitter page has been taken down, and they got an egg up there. You know how some people had that
egg?
Yeah,
there was no profile, no picture.
No picture, nothing. They just got the egg, and she only got 9 followers. So I'm just letting y'all know, when you go to controversial people Twitter sites, the beast is watching, and they going to fuck with your Twitter. Mm. I just want the beast to know, I ain't gonna fuck with the bitch no more. Don't fuck with my Twitter, you motherfuckers. Leave me the fuck alone, you animals.
Unbelievable. Wow.
But you know, we talked about that on the way over here this evening, and I had a different kind of spin on that, in that when she was first, you know, illuminated, not in terms of Illuminati, but just blowed up, so to speak. Mm-hmm. And then what you said happened, my thoughts on it was, if anybody's at work here, they're trying to, like, make this woman over, if you want to call her loosely a woman.
I read a timeline, too. It was all hateful, evil shit, even before she got stolen on. This was a problem bitch before she got stolen on.
See? So,
but she's got a lot of company out here, quite frankly, and yeah, they needed to kind of shut sister. They need to shut that down. Well, you got one, too?
Oh, my sister ain't shit.
Damn. Ooh. I didn't get me started.
My sister ain't about shit.
Yeah.
And my baby mama. The police broke that bitch arm. When they told me the police broke her arm, I was like, yeah, this bitch ran him out. I was laughing. I was like, that bitch talking crazy than the police.
Wow.
Man, I knew we had a lot in common, but I had a sister, my best friend, who's a captain on the police force, man. She talked crazy than him, man. He was like, man, come on, man. You know that your brother's my boy. Oh, you bitch motherfucker.
I want to see what I'm saying.
No, this is my baby mama. My baby mama, the police, broke that bitch arm, and she ain't getting no money for the shit. So all that I'm going to sue you shit, bitch. You ain't got shit but a broke arm and a bootleg check for me, you bum ass bitch.
How long ago was that?
Well, this happened a while ago. My daughter was still young enough to still be in the car seat in the car.
No. Oh, well, that was a long time
ago. They broke that bitch arm. Now tell me I'm lying. I know you listening, you bum ass bitch. You got your arm. They broke your arm, bitch. Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Anyway. Oh, the number, 323-965-1600. I need to have some caffeine. Look, I forgot.
What's wrong with you? You got them sucking on them titties.
Corey.
Oh, well, I'm sorry. You got a
mouth. This the bootleg show, dog.
You got her titties out like ain't nobody going to say shit. What the fuck is this?
I need a little sip.
Man,
it's just
quit making excuses for being who you are and pull out the real shit you do.
It's diet cream soda
and a hair on it.
Funny, Corey.
Anyway, I want to back to the super sock bitch. Listen,
when you say super sock, you know what made me think of? I'm sorry. You know, you remember what was it? Super sock and Jen? Well, she could be super sock and chin.
Super, what is that?
You don't remember that drink?
No.
Socko and Chin?
Just showed her age on
It's not
radio.
Age. It's a West Coast thing. Bobby, you don't know
that?
No,
it's West Coast.
That?
I'm not from here.
You're not from here either? But see, you saw a poetess. She was cracking up. Anyway, it was a drink.
Hey, do we have another color?
If you listen to any N.W.A. and all that old Ice Cube stuff, you'd hear it. Super Socko and Chin. But she could be Super Socko and Chin. I just thought about that. I'm just
all the West Coast people, please back Darlene up with this bullshit that nobody know about.
Because I'm clueless.
We're
going to
take a call.
Yeah. We got a caller. Motherfucker, what's up, brother?
Hey.
Are you there?
Hey.
We hoping we get a call from the bitch.
It might be her. What is her name? Can we say her name?
Let's blow the bitch up. I say the bitch name. Let me get it off my phone. Give a fuck.
So, Corey, she never hits you back on Twitter?
I ain't going back on that bitch Twitter now. Fuck all that shit.
He's scared? Oh, Corey is scared.
I don't want the motherfucker knocking at my door talking about, look, we need to keep this bitch out of the club, baby.
What was her name?
I'll get the bitch name. I'm getting the bitch name right now. Mm. I don't give a fuck about this bitch.
Now, Corey, do you see a relation between all these super women on these action films now and that kind of behavior?
Well, bitches act like they superheroes until you bring them down to earth. Then they become women again, which is really sad.
On the way to the hospital.
Can I say the bitch, Twitter on here, even though they took the Twitter off.
They took it off. Yeah, it is public.
This is some new shit. Her Twitter name is @ Shadea Lane. It's @SHIDEALANE. I'm trying to blow you up, bitch. Call the motherfucking, call the 5150 show.
Well, we do have a caller now.
323-965-1600. What's up, caller?
Damn right, this be Hellboy. What's happening?
What up? Who is this?
I'm on there as B Hellboy 37.
Oh, that's
B-O-Boy 37. That's your Twitter name?
No, that's my name when I'm chatting with everybody online.
Oh, there you go.
You like little girl on
So everybody on there know I'm making really foul comments, but you know, whatever.
That's what's up. Get it on.
Real quick. So I've seen the video, right?
Yeah.
And so I thought it was the funniest video ever. So I showed my girl the video, right?
Uh-huh.
And we laughed and laughed and laughed about the shit, right?
Yeah.
So on Saturday morning, we had an argument, right? Now I'm 6'3", about 250.
Uh-oh.
Oh, man. Got into an argument. My girl socked me in the face.
Women are violent.
And I think it's just, what's really tripped me out about the whole thing is that it's just this whole, now my girl's small. She's like maybe 5'3", about 120 pounds, socked me in the face twice.
We want to know what you did after she hit you in the face.
No, but see, because they're just assuming that they won't hit him back. But why would you test anybody?
Well, we're going to find out what he did.
Sorry, caller. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
After she struck you, sir.
No, I mean, she got it right. I mean, it's just a real culture of disrespect right now where women feel like, a lot of women, I'm not going to say all women, but a lot of women feel like the chivalry rules are still intact, but all the other rules don't apply anymore. Like, you know, they can go out and make money like a man, do all the things that men can do, but they can hit you, and a man can't hit you back. Now the same thing, like if I was arguing with a dude, and a dude ran up in my face, I'd sock him, like my girl ran up in my face, and I didn't sock her. But the thing is, if it was a dude, like I told her, I was like, if you was a dude, I would have laid you out. And I ate it because, you know, we have a child. You know, all that whole story.
The child needs to see that jaw.
No, but here it is, caller. You still have to kind of manhandle somebody. In other words, when you try to stop him, too, that's what I hated to see about my mother, because my dad still had to, you have to still stop them. So then they try to take that into, oh, he, you know what I'm saying, was fighting
me
back.
Like, I roughhouse her because I scooped her up and shit.
Because you're trying to stop everything. Mm-hmm.
Right, and, you know, police got called and had to explain. I'm glad I didn't have to go to jail because I'm not even from here.
Who called the police?
Like, oh, shit. So, say what?
Who called the police?
She did. So here's the thing. I was like, look, I ate the punch. Listen, check it out. I ain't going to call the police on you. It'll be a bad move if I call the police on you. You'll have to go to jail. It'll be real fucked up. So, I'm not going to call the police on you. So, she went outside and called the police herself. Police showed up. And I told him, I was like, look, she socked me in the face twice and scratched me all up. And since she didn't deny it, they looked at her. But they was like, look, y'all going to be all right? Because we don't want to come back out here. And they left. Now, if it was me stomping her or punching her or something, I probably would have went to jail. But the thing about it is, like, I'm not from this city. I don't really have anybody catch me. I don't got nobody to bail me out. So I was really not trying to call the police.
Can I tell you something,
man? I figured I'd get blamed on it. Like, you know what I'm saying?
I got something to tell you, man.
I get blamed. Say what?
I got something to tell you. You seem like a really nice guy. Like, I'm listening to you talk and the way he carrying himself. He seemed like a cool dude. But if a bitch will hit you and then call the police, you don't never need to go around that bitch again. And that's real shit. That bitch is going to set you up to fail.
They already have a kid together.
Ago, but it's too late. It's too late.
Yeah, they have a kid together. Well,
hey, man, thanks for the call, brother. Man.
Thanks, though.
I don't know nothing about chivalry.
Hey, good luck to you, man. Yeah. Good luck to you.
Chivalry is nothing. All I know is when bitches get stole on and they have a seizure, they be shakery. Bitch, I'm about to teach you some shakery.
Okay, let's take another caller. Caller, go ahead.
Hey, what's going on, man? It's J.R. Gray from Muskegon, Michigan.
All right. Hey, Muskegon, Michigan?
Yeah, man. Corey Holcomb, man, I just want you to know, man, you was my idol. When I say idol, nigga, I mean, damn. I mean, every joke, everywhere, I repeat your shit, man.
That's what's up.
It's too fucking funny, dog.
That's what's up.
See? So my thing on my old pussy ass nigga, I just got off the phone.
I know, man. He let that bitch hit him and call the cops on him. And then he put a baby in the bed.
Did what you said do. Just go ahead and get one of them empty ass TV big screen boxes and put it in the back of her building and watch them niggas break in.
Right.
No way, you're too much.
Right. And I want to say to all the dudes who got crazy sisters, you got to, that's a bad idea.
Take them to the projects. Take them on that street where, you know, ain't nothing but crackheads and them niggas that sag all day with the XXX white teeth.
Right.
Put a face on their ass and bust it down. Talk about my mom, some shit. You know, that's what I would have did. Would have fucked it up.
But see, look, Corey, now you're talking about getting yourself in jeopardy, right? Doing
I didn't say it. I didn't finish it.
No. Oh, God. But look, all I'm saying is people that act, conduct themselves that way, it is a matter of time anyway. So if you just get away from them, if you don't have any children, whatever, there's nothing that you need to work out with them, and you go, eventually something's going to happen to that person, because not just them that they're treating like that. If a person, like I said, if they're going to push somebody like that, their buttons, their man or their brother or their kids, it's eventually going to come back on them somewhere. It's going to happen like that in that bus, because you think that girl conducts herself all the time like that with anybody.
You can see her tweets that she was getting mad when people was tweeting her about what happened. She was talking crazy then. And
see,
shit.
So she couldn't even calm herself down and not even respond. You don't even have to. You don't even have to. Act, you could act like
you're
not
even
there.
Yeah, when you cuss a motherfucker out by text, something wrong with you.
Yeah, yeah. You they don't even know if you're there or watching, but shit, you can respond to them. Yeah, there's something ill about them. So
yeah.
Just yeah. Another caller. Go ahead. Caller, go ahead.
Thanks for that call, brother.
Yeah, thank you for calling in. Sorry. Go ahead.
We have a lady.
Am I on?
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, okay, yeah, but I feel the same way, kind of, but differently. It's like, yeah, she deserves it because you don't pop off in a dude's face and hit him and don't expect to get hit. That's like fantasy shit because you don't know a nigga's breaking point.
Right.
Yeah, you do.
But
yeah,
it's so, like, pussy-ass dudes going like, yeah, she deserved it, and I would have did the same thing. No, they wouldn't do the same fucking things. They're scared as fuck about the cops and whatnot.
Hey, sister, you talking out of both sides of your mouth right about now.
A lot of people are scared of the cops, and they wouldn't do it.
No, but what I'm saying is she says she understand, but then he's a pussy-ass nigga for not breaking the bitch jaw. You know, it's like...
No, you got me wrong. I'm saying there's a lot of dudes that claim they would do the same thing, but they wouldn't. The reason women getting like this, they think that they could run over dudes and jump in their face because dudes ain't been... They ain't been dudes lately. They more bitch than a bitch.
But you know
what?
They
ain't been dudes for a long time.
You can't really pick them out of a crowd, because that's a day-to-day proposition, because that guy that put up with that shit today, he the one that made the news tomorrow.
I know what you're saying, Bobby. Mm-hmm. You're saying the nice guys that build up, then
Man,
they kill every motherfucker.
Lord have mercy.
they kill the bitch and the neighbor that was laughing.
Hey, man. Be a nice guy to get some pussy. A nice guy will actually be a nice guy.
No, it really ain't that kind of world, sister, because a nice guy has a breaking point just like everybody else does. And nice. You ain't going to see it coming.
Guys who are nice are bad for the world because of...
What the...
Guys who are nice get ran over.
And
then when they finally do something to take up for themselves, they be on that build-up mode where they snap off and hurt a whole bunch of people that ain't got nothing to do with the shit. Ooh. So that's why nice guys are a problem. You should have a balance where you're nice to people, but at the same time, you will beat the shit out of motherfuckers if
you
he come with
know.
That bullshit.
Exactly. You let them know.
So nice motherfuckers, I don't like nice motherfuckers. When motherfuckers be too nice and shit,
You really don't mean it anyway, because, you know, you've been masking these feelings, because people don't say shit that hurt your fucking feelings, and you put that show on for
them. We know a guy. He's a very nice guy. He does a radio show. His name is Zoe. And he's too nice, in my opinion. I'd be wanting him to snap off and check a motherfucker, but I'd never see him do it. And I'd be wanting to tell him, like, damn, Zoe, when you finally check a motherfucker, you're going to kill everybody.
I don't think you ain't look deep enough into that brother. That's a dark side to that nigga.
That's scary.
I'm fucking with Zoe. We got to get ready to take a break.
Yeah.
Sister, thanks for your opinion.
Yeah, thank you.
Keep calling. And if you want to get somebody some pussy on the show, whether it be me, Darlene, or Bobby, leave your number with a poet. She running the board for us, this motherfucker.
Anyway, we'll be right back.
Sit back and smoke with
my
you.
God.
Okay, yeah.
What up? What up? Say what? Say what? Say what?
What's up?
You know what's up?
phone coming on. Girl, you got me wide open, waiting all day and I'm hoping. So baby, don't front, backseat Jeep, you know what I want.
The old folk portion of the show, man.
Elderly portion. Get an elderly, get an elderly song built up for Bobby. Are we on the air?
What?
I was telling Bobby I was on the plane with Smokey Robinson.
Yeah.
That's what that's Bobby prom music and shit.
That's the truth, man.
Did he look like Jermaine Jackson? Did he look like Jermaine Jackson?
Tears of a clown, man.
Tears of a clown.
That's right.
Hey, girl, you want to go over there to the well and fuck? That's your body.
Man.
Well.
Yeah.
The well?
Yeah, the well.
The water well.
Yeah, the water well.
No, the barn.
Except the drink after.
How about the barn?
The barn. The
barn. I remember when we played.
Back house.
Shoot them up, bang, bang, baby.
Look in the back seat of this. Big
Continental.
Right.
Continental.
That 980s, man. Shit.
Let me go with my mama poke.
A panel. You know what a panel is?
A panel.
Oh, boy.
Tell us what a panel is and how did you find out about them?
A panel, because we've had them in our family. Well, do you know what an El Camino is?
Yeah, we know what an El Camino is.
Okay, you don't know what a panel is. Seriously?
No, I don't.
It looks like a van, and it looks like a you know, they have the two doors that open up in the back. It looks like a big van.
Oh, I didn't know.
Yeah.
That's why I asked you.
Okay, it's anyway. I
I'm
didn't know.
I'm ignorant until you enlighten me.
I didn't know. I thought you were Mr. Automobile Man. I don't know.
I'm not no automobile man.
I didn't know, Corey. Okay.
Back to the bitch who got punched. we done put your Twitter out there. Bitch, get at us on the radio. We want to hear from you. I know you can't talk like you want to. You was texting and shit, but we want to talk about your jaw and see how it healed up. And we want to ask you why you put that fake-ass picture looking innocent on your shit.
I got to say, but they took the new picture down. I wanted to see
now
that.
Now they took the new picture down. Her lawyer, I'm telling you, that's all that man, them people orchestrating that shit.
I'm wondering if we can Google her yet. You think she's all over that, right? Like, they probably have pictures.
On YouTube, they take shit off YouTube. And now what they have been putting on YouTube is the shit where they show only the bus driver get up and hit her.
They don't show all the
They don't show all of the shit before that, but they show her talking like, he got up.
What was it?
And then they show the bus driver like a big black dude get up. Roar. You know how they make it to make the black man look bad and shit? They don't show this bitch before
he
that.
Yeah, it.
My man, go kick your ass.
But now, wasn't she into
it? My man hit me way harder than you, motherfucker.
Look, was she talking to the dude in the safety vest? What did he have to do with anything? Is he like site security? What is his deal?
I don't know. He can't be security.
But it looked like she was almost yelling at him, too. Like he
was trying to block her from getting over there and getting stuck again.
Oh, okay. Okay. Because I was wondering what was his deal.
Shaddai Lane, call in, you lousy bitch. We want to talk about your job.
Oh, wow. That's really going to get her to come.
That's what make her come. She might drive up here and hit me.
Corey, it's time for some compassion for this young lady, man. We need to get her a first class.
We got some violin music.
Ain't that something?
We need to get her a first class ticket to Afghanistan, all expenses paid.
Oh, okay. I know you're going
let
with that,
Bobby. Let
that bitch
go out there and
fit in. What's
her name again? Shot in the head.
What?
Shaddai Lane. Hold on. Let me get
Shaddai Lane.
Yeah. Let me find the bitch name again. Funk ass. Heifer hoe. Is this such thing as a heifer hoe?
Lane.
It is now.
Did you find the shit?
No.
Your computer gonna start freezing fucking with this bitch. them Illuminati motherfuckers got that bitch
Shaddai
back.
How do you spell it? Let me see.
It's at H.
No, I mean, what is her name?
I don't know the whole name, but the Twitter, what we found the bitch is at Shaddai Lane. Super Sock Joe, we want you to call in, bitch. Get up. You ain't sleep. You ain't got nothing going for you. They try to act like she was a little girl, too. This bitch is 25 or 26. It's one of them. It don't matter either one, bitch. Your period still coming
in.
Were any charges filed against anybody?
News for Shaddai bus driver uppercut.
That's funny.
What happened when you Googled it? What is it?
That, it said that. She's 25.
No, so there's her response. It says, girl... uppercut by Cleveland bus driver response.
Okay.
Let's see if that bitch talking on that motherfucker.
Did anybody catch a case in this?
Not yet,
situation?
But you know
yeah,
what?
They gonna catch a case. He they gonna is. Try to sue the bus company and shit. They can't sue dude.
That's why they let him go on like some kind of a temporary suspension.
Girl, uppercut. Is that the bitch?
Yeah.
Oh, that's an ugly picture of the bitch. Now, see the picture they had on.
No, but that's the picture that she's been. That's a still from one of her interviews on the news.
Yeah,
that's a still picture.
Yeah, that bitch got that plantation look right there.
Oh, look at this. What is that?
Is that her boyfriend? He got caught in the middle of all that bullshit.
That ain't him.
Well, who is it?
That's a show. She was on a show. She was on a radio show. See, there it is.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, they show the video. Okay. Anyway, no, that's not. That is a bad picture of her, though. Look, that's her live on the... wow, she kind of looks like a boy, right?
Right. If I close it. God damn it.
Bless her heart. Is that from him, that little scar, or is that what he was making fun of?
That's what he was making fun of.
Wasn't very nice.
She been cut and shot?
Oh, well, that's not very nice.
She got some chorizo on her face?
You know what? Chorizo, but still, that's funny. That's a good one. Oh, my God. Manchas. Manchas are stains.
Oh, yeah?
So anytime somebody says something, you got something. Ooh, you got a
it's
mancha.
It's got negro on her face.
You got a mancha on your
skin. A mancha?
Yeah, that's a stain.
We call it herpes where I'm from.
They got manchas down there.
That bitch looked like she had a rough life, too.
Dang, that's
terrible. You know this bitch will never heal mentally from this because the fame she getting, she know is people laughing at her.
Because they'll
nobody's on your side.
It, right.
I know it's probably girls out there. He ain't had no business hitting you. But as soon as your back turned, he'll be like, this is the bitch you gay.
That's messed up. Corey, that is too funny.
It's
that
my rub it in laugh.
No, that's demonic.
American
okay.
Team.
Caller, let's take
we
a caller.
Call.
Go ahead.
Is
yep.
it the bitch?
No, it's not.
Oh, what's up, brother? Yeah. My bad. We tried to egg this bitch in the call.
What's up, man? I'm calling from Memphis.
Oh,
what's up, Memphis? Yeah. I got to get out to Memphis.
Man, I had a great time in Memphis last week.
Oh, for real, though?
Yeah, man. I came for... Dana Davis's memorial service, but I went by Memphis Sound and hung out over at Stax Record Museum and just enjoyed the flavor of.
Did you go by Elvis Crib?
Asked him, did he
pass right by that motherfucker, man. You know what? You can't go nowhere within a mile radius of that. You can't use the bathroom without having a ticket to the Graceland Mansion, man. It's one of the greatest money making machines in the world. That man been worth more dead than he was alive for about 25, 30 years. Great city, yeah. Memphis, though. I love Memphis.
Go ahead, caller. Did you have a question?
I was calling because I've been trying to get to you guys' show since you guys were on the Foxhole. But I'm a huge fan of you guys. When Corey came here with Shaq All-Stars Comedy Special, we were all there in the house.
Oh,
and it was a trip because one of my homeboys was like, "Well, I'm gonna bring my girlfriend," and me and the rest of the guys, you know, we knew what kind of comedy Corey was gonna do.
Oh,
like,
man,
you gonna bring your girlfriend? He was like, "Yeah, I'm gonna bring my old lady." I don't think you should do that, dog. Like, no, she'll have a good time. Okay.
Uh-oh.
How much is his child support now?
He had to bring her. She made him bring her.
Is he still with her?
Well, see,
No, I'm saying. She wasn't going to make the cut no way then. Yeah.
Put all his clothes out on the porch with some sweet tea.
It was just funny. Like, it was funny watching him looking at her, because every time Corey was doing a joke, that mouth would drop, and then his mouth would drop, and he'd look at her, and then he'd be looking at me, and I'd be like, "I told you not."
Oh, he couldn't even laugh freely. He couldn't even freely laugh. That is messed up.
He's in jail.
He couldn't freely laugh.
Oh, my God. That's terrible. I know y'all had an extra good time just watching that.
He in jail. When you can't laugh, you in jail.
Hey, Bill Street, right after that show, I was in Memphis that weekend also. That was the Southern Heritage Classic weekend. And right after the show, Corey and I and a couple of my friends were standing outside. And believe it or not, two doctors who were gynecologists came up to Corey.
Gynecologists, yeah.
They came up to Corey and gave him major props, which was interesting, man, because sometimes the truth really does affect people in a very powerful way.
And it's so many people out here trying to be sugarcoated with all this mess, because we've been at my job dying laughing about the video with this chick getting that uppercut.
Right, because, you know, and the reason people laugh is because they saw what she did before. We on the internet, we looking at a picture of this bitch, and
she got Ohio State behind her, like, so she's taking a cute picture, like, I guess she goes there.
She's trying to take the innocent face pictures and shit, bitch. We know you ain't shit.
Ain't no bitch like that going to no college. What the
Some goof-ass motherfucker in college liked the hoe. She sucked his dick right.
But that is a much better picture. She looks cute right there, though. She cleaned her act up on that one.
Go back to them other pictures.
Where are they at? Where were they at?
And then they bring out the history talking about this motherfucker being shot about 3 times and stabbed twice.
Mm. Yeah, that picture with the bitch got on the pink pants. That's the Twitter picture they put up for the hoe.
I mean, this motherfucker is one of them mess-ass bitches that just like to get an ass whooped. Don't nobody see this shit yet?
And they don't know what it is. People see it as just the media and the powers that be, the evil motherfuckers, won't say that this is an ain't shit bitch. They need an ain't shit bitch category in this world.
But they won't do that, because the minute you say one of them ain't shit, the rest of them going to assume that you talk about all of them. But really, all you're doing is just pulling out all the bullshit out the back closet.
Well, you know, it's like this. Women who conduct themselves in a manner of a lady, and, you know, for me, and I think most guys, you're going to get the respect you deserve. Mm-hmm. And if you know a girl conducts herself like a lady, and you see somebody fucking with her, I'm talking about the average man, be ready to kill a motherfucker. Be like, who the fuck, they fucking with, what's the name for a lady? A lady who
is it a lady? What?
Like a lady who conducts herself right. Is it a name for
a lady? That's it.
Proper
man.
Lady.
They fucking with Beatrice.
You know what? Oh, you're looking for an actual.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Is there a lot of bullshit Beatrices out there? Yeah, Beatrice, that's probably a bullshit bitch.
I was going to say Bertha, but that's not. No, that's a. Oh, well, Ethel. Bertha. Ethel.
Ethel?
Oh,
no,
Ethel.
Ethel, old bitch. Ain't no young Ethels.
Here, probably. Anyway. Oh, Elizabeth.
Hey, thanks they call, Memphis.
Kathleen, yeah. Kathy.
What else we got cooking on the board?
Hey, caller, go ahead. Caller, where'd you go?
Yeah, how you doing?
There
you doing?
It is.
How's it going?
What's up, brother?
Oh, man, this is Black Boss, and I just appreciate your show, and I'm just trying to learn how I can link up and listen to it more free. I'm on my cell phone right now.
Wow.
But normally, I mean, the only reason I know you're out there is because I've been catching these old YouTube videos. I caught one on about Obama, and I thought that was interesting. I hear you out there talking about the, you know, child support and that chick getting that uppercut. That shit was slick, but, you know.
Right. Oh, so you don't have a computer on you right now, so you can't really get a good feed of it.
I do have a computer. I got an internet. I paid my bill. I paid my internet bill, so I got a computer right here in front of me.
Oh, so you're not watching it on the computer right now?
Well, that's what I'm trying to do. I'm not computer savvy, though, you know. I just watch YouTube and... Will Star and whatnot, and you know, but I see your show on an old YouTube video, but I want to know how do I get on the show to look at the show, look at the live show. Like, right now, I'm just listening to you on my cell phone.
Right, that's what we're trying to tell you. Right, so if you're on your computer, go on RMC, so you're like www.rmconair.com.
Okay.
Go to the upper right corner and click on live. Watch live.
Watch live. And also, I want to let the people out there know when you bring up this bitch name, what is
Shidea.
It?
Shidea. It's Shidea. Yeah.
They got images of the bitch. I want everybody to call in and let us know what you think about how this bitch look.
Well, I like this. The scar looks slick. I like this scar. I thought that
he's
was
turned
slick,
on by this guy. What?
I and she was scrapped. She had some big, she was scrapping back. I was like, damn.
Oh, right. He was turned on. Like, look. Look at hell. You.
Right. I wanted to.
She doesn't like lock him, sock him when dude hit him, though. I was like, damn.
Right, I wanted to nut on the scar and see if it'll heal it. I feel like if she let me nut on her scar,
that's pure protein,
it can
yeah.
be gone in a couple of weeks.
Why not? But look, she's not a bad-looking young lady. That's too bad. You know what I'm saying? That's too
she
bad.
She ain't no bad bitch either, though.
No, but you feel
that bitch
I'm
got
saying.
To work. Well, nobody gonna take care of that bitch. You got to work, bitch. You can't be laying up in there now.
That's too bad, because that don't go with the look.
Bad bitches ain't got to work. That bitch, is, I wish she would live with a motherfucker trying not to work. Bitch, you better get your monkey ass up and get out here with me. Get your ass up, bitch.
She don't work now. She's famous now.
Shit, well, that bitch gonna have to work. That bitch, everybody think this bitch finna get some paper. This bitch ain't finna get no paper. This bitch ain't finna get no paper. She hit him first. And if anything, they do settle out. They're going to say some lie about what she got. But we, anybody who really sued a motherfucker, know.
Right now, she's getting big buzz off of that uppercut, taking that one to the jaw.
Yeah, all right. That's
oh, look, here goes a Twitter from her before they cut it off.
Oh, what does Twitter say?
Dang, look, that's even a different picture. She looks all done up there. But this
what
different,
does it say on her Twitter picture?
It said,
I mean, on her Twitter thing right
going
there.
To the doctor today to get my jaw repositioned, which she spelled wrong. She said, she spelled it. Repositioned. They gone have to run a few testes on me. So she spelled reposition and test. She put testes.
You know they put that up there on purpose. I mean, for people to see that her literacy level, even though people can say it was the phone that typed it wrong and all that shit, but just
no.
by the way her lip hanging on that one picture, I believe.
But right here she put, it looks like she puts testes. Look, it's testes on me. They're going to run right. a few testes on me. Bless her heart.
They keep showing it on this one site where the bus driver just
it is over and over again. They edit it, look, and he's like, bam, 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 bam. Look, that is terrible.
That is
look,
fucking
Bobby,
hilarious.
They keep playing it over and over again.
I remember.
And they should.
At one time, people were saying there's no talent in America. This is fucking talented.
He should have been on The X Factor.
Right.
Mm. Or not The X Factor, America's Got Talent.
Fuck singing, watch this.
Well, maybe it'll be a turning point.
Oh, dude, you just made my gut hurt.
You think it'll be a turning point, Bobby?
I'm prayerful that it is. I'm hopeful that it is.
Oh, my God.
Not to the extent where we go back to the days where you can just literally drag a woman down the street and the police would salute you. You know, but in hindsight, that was a dangerous period, too, because women would allow men to go upside their head, and then they would go in the bedroom and go to sleep and wake up dead, you know, because a woman done threw some hot water and grits and all that old kind of shit on the nigga, you know.
Really be sleep around bitches?
Man, you'd be amazed, man, at how many people have woke up in the burn ward.
You say in the burn ward.
Dang.
That's an old ass saying, Bobby.
Let's take another caller, though. Let's go. Caller, go ahead.
Hey, yo, what's up? It's Dwight Kirkpatrick.
Hey.
Hey, Mr. Kirkpatrick.
Man, I want to chime in on, what's up?
What's up, Mr. Kirkpatrick?
Oh, shit, man. I want to chime in on baby girl getting a glass jaw one time.
Right, we want to hear that shit.
Man. I said that bitch got what she deserved, though, because ain't no way in hell you go just, like, hit some dude and think, you know, oh boy ain't going to hit her ass back. That motherfucker's about that shit, obviously, the way he got out. That's like some old granddaddy shit.
Right. Mm-hmm.
You know, and ain't no way in hell I'm going to do that. But on the serious issue with that, though, she waited for that nigga to start driving. And then she going to hit the nigga thinking he wasn't going to do shit. So that motherfucker stopped instantly on the dime, got out. Busted her ass up, and now everyone trying to give old boy a hard time. Part of it was her shit. You know, hell, that was good shit.
Mm-hmm.
Let me tell you something, man.
So when they hit her, What's up?
And she hit him while he was driving the bus.
Yeah.
That ought to have been a case right there.
Yeah, man. You got other people's lives in jeopardy, you know?
Sitting on that bus need to sue her ass. If she gets cashed out from whatever Cleveland Transit, once she get cashed out, the other motherfuckers like that one nigga with the housing authority outfit on, he needs to fucking cash out on her.
Yeah.
His life in jeopardy.
The one with the vest, a little security vest.
So how did she avoid an assault charge?
The housing authority vest shit. Man, that motherfucker need to cash. Man, I'm telling you, that everybody on that bus got a case.
They don't always arrest you the day it happened. What's happening now is they letting this shit die down, just like with that Trayvon Martin shit. They gonna arrest the hoe.
Trayvon who?
That Trayvon. I don't
who?
That
Trayvon
baby.
Who?
I don't care about that. I'm talking about baby. Man, I'm talking about this shit right now. That shit's bad.
I know what you're saying, but I'm saying, like, they don't arrest people right away sometime. But trust me, they are aware that bitch hit him while that bus was moving.
See, more
and
so,
that's why when stupid motherfuckers be talking about, ooh, she finna get paid, I be like, y'all some stupid motherfuckers. This bitch ain't finna get no paper.
You know, but it's always like that on the motherfucking city buses because, up in Oakland and shit, those AC transit buses, niggas always be trying to do it live. But niggas never try to hit the bus driver. It'd be like, motherfuckers going wild on the bus. You know, sometimes motherfuckers fly out that little open window in the back and shit. But,
right.
You know, it ain't like you going to put everybody at risk by hitting the nigga driving the bus. So baby girl filed for that shit there. She got what she had coming.
It's not over, Corey. It's not over. I mean, look, there's a lot of witnesses that are coming forward. And, it's just starting with that case. But they're all responding with the same... that she was drunk, she was belligerent, she was obnoxious when she got, even before she got on the bus. So,
but real talk, darling, but not to cut you off.
Mm-hmm, no, go ahead.
Yeah, you did.
Hey, baby girl, I don't even call her girl. She like one of those butch broads and shit up there, realizing she just realized she was a female. She wasn't no dude. So she can't just hit no dude and, try and get all the fucking, I look like a dude, I'm a dude shit. But the moment some other nigga hit her, now she's going to, fucking roll her hair in little pigtails and try to put her little cutest picture on the internet and say, look at me, I'm a chick. Some dude just hit me, but you was just up there trying to act like a dude.
Right.
She's trying to have her cake eat it, too. So, like I said, I hope some other motherfucker bust her upside her motherfucking head for that shit.
If I ever see that bitch walking down the street and she pregnant, I'm going to uppercut her stomach like that. Try to save the world from the bullshit.
Oh, my God, Corey.
Other than that, y'all right. Doing good, man. I'm glad to, catch you guys on this late night on this motherfucking internet, on the RMC air and stuff. So,
All right, well, we sure appreciate the phone calling. Please call again.
Yeah,
man.
Thanks for that.
Hey, Porter. To set it up in a way where we can see the callers too, if they have the cameras.
Yeah, if they have
Skype some of our callers so they can get their airtime on and shit, and plug their shit they trying to plug.
I'm over here yelling,
For this week, we want everybody to see the passion in their eyes as they talk about this lousy bitch that's kicking up all this commotion in the world that ain't about shit.
And also, we could have asked them.
You took a productive man from his job. You know your life ain't shit. You a bum-ass bitch. I'm trying to geek up the call. It's your mama fault. Where your mama at? Where's your guy mama? Because
they were saying that that's what got her mad, that he when she didn't want to pay and she already walked past him, that he told her. He called her out. And said, your mama too, whatever. She said, you keep talking like that to me, I'm going to spit on you or I'm going to get you. And she did, so.
So, what else we got happening on that board there? I see that light.
Another caller. Go ahead. You're on.
All right, this is Eugene from Cleveland.
Oh.
Hey!
Was you on the bus? Were you on the bus?
Cleveland in the house.
I know somebody that bus driver works for what's called RTA. That's the company he works for. Now, I know somebody that would know. Even though everybody knows that guy wasn't wrong for doing that. She hit him and spit on him. That's why they're trying to clean up her image and shit, Corey. They are going to just get that broad probably like 40, 50 grand.
For what?
They ain't going to get that bitch shit.
They just, they just wanted to go away, man.
This going away with this damn videotape and a decent lawyer, man, they going to run that bitch out of court. They're going to be like, Exhibit A, just hit the button.
Let's hear what he got to say. Because a lot of people think people get paid in lawsuits and shit. This shit is funny.
That shit's over with, man. They done stopped giving away money like that a long time ago.
I wouldn't be surprised. That's what's unfortunate about it. Like he said, I would not be surprised that she got some kind of chips, which is so unfortunate. No, I wouldn't be surprised.
Caller, go ahead.
Go away, man. That's what I'm hearing for somebody that works there, man. They just want this shit to go away. The internet, you can't get rid of that video now. It's gonna be somewhere.
Well, whoever told you that must work in the retard department, because it's real simple. Once you set a precedent like that, if she gets paid for doing that, it's going to be somebody every week starting some shit.
But this,
there have been a couple incidents that they've been talking about in the news. Other people have done stuff to these bus drivers. I guess everybody, like they said, everybody knows that there's probably going to be a payout for this. There's already been a couple of incidents where people tried to, provoke these bus drivers, man. It's crazy, man.
I want to let everybody out there know that when you go to court, you get paid according to your class. If that was a Caucasian woman from Beverly Hills who got punched by a bus driver, she would get paid. She would get a big settlement. But when you are a bum-ass bitch who come from a crack mama and a bathroom with a dirty mop in it and a sink full of dishes and Hennessy, you ain't getting shit. Them motherfuckers pay you according to your class. I'm telling you, this bitch, when it's all said and done, somebody might cut the bitch a bill for what they owe, for what the bitch owe for them giving her attention and shit. Watch the movie Chicago, that musical, the latest one. They give you the razzle dazzle, they put you in the spotlight, but they on to the next story in a minute. Bitch, you ain't getting shit. Get your bum ass out of here.
Wow.
And that is what you said, Bobby. You said
one more call.
If they pay that bitch for that,
man, it's gonna be out of control.
Open season.
Yeah.
But that's how it is anyway with frivolous lawsuits. They're out there. It is.
They're harder and hard. It's hard to get paid on a legitimate lawsuit.
Right, but
nowadays.
People like that, they have got nothing better to lose. They got time.
But it's hard for a lawyer to. I mean, if goes in front of a jury, how in the hell are you gonna say don't believe your lying eyes? Okay, you didn't just see this bitch come on this bus. And assault this
bus
driver.
But at this point, it's gone so far anyway, she's got to roll with the punches because there are people behind her that are
NCAA,
trying to get something.
The NCAA, ain't nobody coming forward in favor of this bitch.
I didn't say that.
This bitch is standing there by herself.
The people that are, whoever's talking to her and having her, because she's not doing this on her own. Clean her act up and doing all that, right.
She fucking with a hustling ass lawyer.
There you go.
But in the end, they'll get a lawyer some money before they get that bitch some money.
Yeah. But see, there's lawyers on both sides of that, and there's not a lawyer that won't get disbarred and fired if he's defending, if he's representing the city of Cleveland or the state of Ohio. If he loses that, he's out of work. He'll never get another case in his life if he can't win that case.
We're going to take one more caller, though. Go ahead. Caller, go ahead.
Hello?
Yeah.
What's up, man?
What's up? It's Chirac from Chicago.
Chi-town, what it do?
I'm looking at this bitch Twitter right now. She like she belong on the bus.
She back up and running, but Corey's too scared to go back on there.
How many followers does she have now?
On this Twitter, she got 6,000 plus followers.
Yeah, that's the one I saw. So they must have put it back up. They took it down for a minute.
It's like it's at Miss Lane 419. It's Miss MV Lane 419.
Okay, we're trying to go to this shit, too. We want to look at the bitch.
Oh, you want to do that?
Do we got a world's record for calling a girl a bitch on the radio?
Do you have the world? You probably do, Corey.
Pull up the bitch on the damn YouTube.
Her Twitter?
Pull up the bitch Twitter. What is it again?
Because her can't look normal in this picture.
You know what?
That bitch got a superhero jaw, man. She took that shit like that.
Where's her Twitter?
We got Darlene trying to go to this Twitter at Ms.
No, look, it says right there. Oh, this is somebody else.
M-Z-L-A-N-E.
12 hours ago. Look at that. Sent 10,000. What is that? No.
Can you go to
she got too many. These are all fake. What is that?
Hold on. Can you go to the one that Portis just said?
I don't see it. Where is it at?
At M-Z
Lane.
Yikes.
419.
You're not on Twitter.
No. Where's Twitter?
It's when you punched in Twitter.
But where's Twitter? I'm not on it.
Well, you just got to go.
Can you Google? Can you Google?
Do you have a Twitter?
Not on here. Do I?
Are you playing it off because you don't want to go on
there? I don't do Twitter on here. I barely even do it on my phone. I don't use Twitter a lot. That's narcissistic.
You know what? People out there, she don't want to go to that bitch Twitter.
Damn you,
Corey. What I said. I'm telling
you. Why don't you
use yours? She playing it off. I ain't going to the bitch Twitter.
I ain't opening it up.
I told you, they shut my Twitter down for a whole day and a half.
I'm not doing it. Go ahead, Bobby. You got a cell phone.
Man, I don't know how to use it.
Bobby's phone don't get Twitter.
Yes, it do. I got
Bobby, it's okay, man. Don't
I stepped
be
it up, man. Hey, man, I stepped it up, man.
No, there's a couple of them, but there's a couple of other ones that
what
have.
What they say, hold on, call and say a Twitter fake.
They made me come up and
hold on, Bobby. I couldn't hear what he said. What happened now?
It's fake, but this is the real Twitter because she got tweets from July on here, and she's still talking. Like, if you read her last tweets, she's still talking crazy to people. Like, her jaw still don't hurt.
Mm. Right, bitch, we know your jaw hurts, you broke crack jaw, bitch. That bitch pillow made out of motherfucking pudding.
But for the record,
that bitch jaw looked like Peyton Manning forehead.
Yo, Corey, why she tweeted Obama? She said, "Mr. President Obama, please fight for us tonight." I bet she wish he was fighting for him while she was on that bus.
Hell yeah.
That's crazy.
This ought to be the last night we talk about
call,
this
man.
This worthless right. ass piece of
thank
shit.
You
because now, she's far too famous, man. Far too famous for a shit starting asshole.
Is this the one you're talking about?
I don't know. I ain't been on the shit. Girl, just Google. Press the shit. You scared to press it? Yeah, you pressed it. They go
boom.
They go fuck your computer.
She said, "I'm 25 with a beautiful 4-year-old."
For our listening audience,
I wonder if she sit through that tape with her 4-year-old.
She got a baby?
She said, "I'm 25 with a beautiful..."
Oh, bitches from the hood got babies.
She said, "I'm 25 with a beautiful 4-year-old daughter, got the mind of a lion, but I represent the bull.
The mind of a lion.
And don't mind working or continuing my education. Love to go to church."
Bitch, you 25. You say you 25. Okay, fuck it. Bitch, what education have you got?
So she said her 4-year-old daughter, so she had her when she was 20.
The mind of a lion. Now, when was the last time her people associated intelligence with
Look what she said right here.
What'd she say? We reading some of her tweets. What did it say?
"Oh, soon as my jaw feel better, you bitches ain't going to be able to tell me nothing. I'm taking some boxing lessons."
Get your superhero jaw ass the fuck out of here. That bitch should be. They need to put on that new movie, Wreck-It Ralph, and just see if he can steal on the bitch. And do something with her jaw. Let's read a couple of her tweets. What's the other one say?
No, that was from her. These are from people.
What that say?
That's from her at Jadea HOV Lane. "I just gotta say, you the truth." Oh, this girl is telling her, "You the truth."
This some bitch. What's the bitch name who we're gonna own?
And then look, why'd she say, "You took that punch like a champ"?
Right.
That's what she said.
They laughing at the bitch.
Exactly. Know, she ain't even realizing that that's a joke. You took the punch like a champ. What the hell? So you gonna okay? Somebody knocked you out like a mug.
It was so ridiculous.
I will pay her to play that video in front of her 4-year-old while I'm there. I'm just putting it out there. I'll give you $1,000 if you let me just watch your child watch that video. I'll give you $1,000. I ain't rich. But $1,000, that's more than you gonna get for giving punch, bitch.
And then these people are the people that are hitting her back. She said, this other girl's like having a Twitter fight with her, and she's like, "Because I'll continuously have bitches like you in check." So this girl's telling her that, and it just goes on and on and on.
What else is saying? What that bitch be saying, though?
Dang. Wait, is it?
"I bet you would, because I just... basic a bitch."
No, cause you just a basic bitch, cause they spell stuff wrong. Look, you just basic bitch. I'm more DirecTV or something. What the hell is that?
That's Shadia. Shadia talking about she DirecTV. No shit, bitch. Oh. I got the internet on my TV.
See, why would you care? Like, who's that? That's what I'm saying on Twitter. How you gonna tweet these
Shadia,
people?
I watched you get stole on in HD, and that shit was beautiful.
No, that girl said that to her. See,
what she say?
That's what that girl's saying to her.
"Uh-huh, what's next? Is that all you..." Wait a minute, is that all? "Bitch, you're..." What did that say? I can't see.
Which one?
It say, "Bitch, you're dismissed."
Yeah, you're dismissed. You know, like Mortal Kombat, you're dismissed. Boom.
She says she dismissed, but she keep talking shit to her.
look at simmer the fuck. Go back to whatever transaction you, or what is it, trash can you climbed out of. Oh, my God.
Well, this bitch can sing, too.
Yeah.
She called the bitch Oscar the Grouch. What that say? What that say?
T-Mac says, Lane, hey, little mama, I respect you, but fuck what these niggas are talking about. It's men out here that would have went to sleep from that punch. In other words, he's saying you took it too? Oh, my he said, God.
He said, hey, little mama, I hear you, but this motherfucker's out here. Who
oh, he's just trying
to
get at her.
Ain't
yeah, that I nothing? Do. Look, he's trying to get at her. He's not dumb.
Shit, her pussy ain't broke.
Oh, and look, she retweeted that. Like, she's proud of it. Look, she retweeted
right.
it.
Right. What
like,
else
look, I want
got?
People to know
I'm
what
I'm telling
he
you, did. This is comedy. What else is on there? This bitch is going to have some class.
This is the girl that's sending this to her. So this is not Shadia. This is the girl that's
what's
like.
What's that bitch name? At what?
At CASSIESE. I wouldn't have to say anything to you if you would have stayed in your damn lane. No one mentioned you, so you are irrelevant. So this girl's telling homegirl that. It's funny. But anyway.
We're sitting here going over the bitch who got super socked on the bus, Twitter. And there's some funny shit on here. As other bitches is getting at her, trying to tell her she made bitches look bad all over the nation.
You know, you see?
We're getting ready to take a break. Shadia, please, the number to call in is 323-965-1600. We hope to hear from you, you broke jaw bitch.
Yeah, because she can speak up for herself. Say something, mama. Go, Bobby.
What's it all about? This crazy love. I love you. You know I would.
Okay, that, no, that's that bitch talking.
See, I can't even turn this motherfucking phone off.
We're back. We sitting there looking at this bitch tweets and shit. This bitch is gone. How the fuck do you think? Do you really think somebody finna give a bitch some money who tweets shit like this? Twitter is the ultimate way to show people who the fuck you are.
Don't just leave it alone. Don't. You don't. You know what I'm saying? Like you're making yourself look real silly.
I punch you just the way you are.
And we really need to go back to that flavor.
Sitting down
of music,
so low,
man.
Like that this, I'm sorry. Sitting down so low like this, my pants making my stomach make me burp.
That's what it need to be, you know, because it'd be less violence in the world.
If it's Shania Lane say, I'm Lil' Kim. I'm Lil' Kim and y'all bitches is Nicki Minaj. Clearly I'm winning. Lil' Kim ain't make no money, you stupid.
He's got it twisted. Oh, she meant to say it the other way around.
No, she did. Quit fucking giving this bitch a pass.
Because that doesn't make any sense. Anyway.
We had this bitch, man.
Oh, I'm going to have to raise these chairs.
And
we
you said there was a woman, that a female of some sort, that actually put something out there that said, under no circumstances should a woman ever be hit, right?
Yeah. Well, that was her, Shania Lane. She
said that.
She thought that under no circumstances should never be hit. What did you learn, bitch?
Well, a woman would never do anything to get hit. Not a woman. Yeah. Now, you know, a female of some sort, different situation.
This bitch say, bitch, get out of my message, you hood.
We have another caller. I was going to say, look, can we get off of this? Oh, we don't have enough time. Darn it.
Can
I was
we get off
what? Oh, yay, we have an half hour. I was just going to say, because I am single, you know.
So you want to talk about that? You know you're sensitive to this shit.
What do you mean I'm sensitive to this? No, I'm saying...
Okay, let's talk about Darlene being single.
Yay.
What? Oh.
Oh, we got another caller. That's okay. Let's take
what's
that.
What's going on, caller?
What's up, caller?
Hey, this is Otis from Texas.
Hey, Otis.
Hey,
Otis. Where you from, Otis?
I'm from Texas.
Oh, another one. Dang.
Okay.
All right, now we're going to switch subject, but I got to throw my piece in this situation.
Right.
I was just arguing with this girl about this situation.
And she slapped her views, you.
Yeah, no, her views was, you know, no man should ever hit a girl. Mm. My thing, yeah, and she's trying to come at me like saying, what if that was your sister that got punched? And I told her straight up, my sister don't do hood rat shit, so she wouldn't even get punched.
Mm-hmm.
So, hey, like I said, hey, I ain't saying that, hey, she got what she deserved. That's just the truth.
Mm-hmm.
I agree with you 100%, Otis. Yeah. The video footage shows that she a funky bitch with nothing to lose. She going to die in the streets. Her four-year-old going to be getting fucked by bullshit niggas like me.
You know.
It is a girl, right? I hope it's a girl.
Yes, but not at that age. You mean later on in life when she...
Yeah, and about her...
But the way you said it sounded...
You got a four-year-old daughter, that mean in about 9 years, niggas going to be fucking that bitch.
Boy, I tell you. Boy.
Tell you,
that bitch going to be getting her throat skeeted on.
What's up with dog name, man? Single. What's up with that? Why are you still single at this age?
Hey, that's a good question.
No, that's a great question. That's a question for a lot of women my age. Why we're single at this age?
Well,
what do you mean?
What he said, what you got to say?
Right, because the man that you're with leaves you for a younger girl, and then that leaves you in a weird bracket. Like, I'm at that age where I'm too old for the young and too young for the real old guys. In other words, I'm in a real weird, you know what? Damn it, Corey, don't do it. What?
Bullshit!
You figure? You almost killed yourself holding your breath like that, damn it.
You almost killed yourself. You sound like Shania Lane. You lied to me.
I got a good look. I got a good old
You might as well tweet people. Fuck y'all. It's hard to get a man
like
that.
Right,
I'm in that middle bracket.
If you just had this arm down right here, have this arm down right here. Put your arm down.
I ain't doing it. I ain't
put your
what
arm
that,
down.
That is right. That's one of the issues right there. Ooh, that bossy ass shit. Put your arm down.
Right.
Put your arm down.
You saw know. That. She tried to make me move my arm.
Well, not as fortunate as you guys to be. Why are you not? You're not married, are you, Bobby? Well, Corey is. See, but.
Between you feeling him, do you feel like it intimidates the guy if you say, well, you know, my ex-man was Ice-T? Because that kind of throws people off, like, oh shit, Colors in the house, you know.
Are you speaking for? Are you speaking for yourself or a population of people?
But we gotta let Bali answer the question.
In general, men, you know.
No, like, well, what's funny is if they don't already know, I don't bring that up, and then eventually they find out. So I already appreciate the fact that they just didn't know, and I'm just another one. I know, but that's what I'm saying. So if they did, most of the time, it doesn't even faze them at that point. Once they do,
so
they
you
already
go somewhere with them. They're gonna be like, "Hey, you know who that is? You know what I mean? Oh, that's my girl, Darlene. Get the fuck out of here. That's old girl."
That's not true. But anyway, no, I don't know. It could be a collection of things, but.
I think men are definitely intimidated that you used to be in a
but
relationship
that's the thing, used
with,
to be, so, and I'm not.
And he still got influence. He could come back and move in if he wanted to.
Here you go. You always go there. That is so funny to me, really.
Yo, D, I'm on my way.
Oh, that was good, Corey. Damn.
did I do it?
We're going to start setting you up for some commercials.
I watched Surviving the Game.
That was a hell of a movie, by the way.
That was a good-ass movie. I don't give a fuck what nobody said. Surviving the Game.
And it was fun. Do you know that? I was out there for a little bit.
Burn!
Wait. You know that Gary Busey was on
that. Hey, look here.
You know crazy-ass Gary Busey was on that movie.
Yeah.
And one time, they were looking for him to do a scene and couldn't find him. Hours apart, they were like, oh my God, we got to do something else. We got to change the set. We got to do something else. They went and found him. He was way out in the woods, because they really were out in the woods, right, in Washington. Somebody was like, we found him. Comes walking in from the woods. There they go. Good one! He comes walking in from the woods, and he's got a girl with him. He's zipping up his pants. How does this look?
Hey,
But he was even.
Hey, Corey.
I love it. I'm a crip walk. I'm a
crip walk.
I'm a crip walk for you.
Hey, Corey. Short story. I had actually just met Darlene during the filming of that movie. I was right before he went to film that movie.
Yeah, because we were way out. It was in Washington.
This brother named Ahmed, he took me up to Ice-T's house because he helped to support the Marcus Garvey School, and I was fundraising for the school at the time. And he stood up and told this amazing story, man. He said that he had to work about 90 days out of the year to support the overhead from all them cats that was hanging out at the little old shop he had down on the bread.
Poor shop, huh?
Yeah. And then what he said, Corey, was, look, if shit get any worse, he looked at old girl and said, "You know what? We might go back to the old business if shit don't pick up."
The old business was better than the new stuff. The new stuff had a gang extra.
What is
drama.
The old business? Was Ice-T actually really a pimp?
What do you mean? No, before he met me.
So he was a pimp before he met you?
He did do dibble dabble in that when he was in Hawaii. When he was in the service, yeah, that's what
so,
he did.
So let me ask you a question. So you was with a man who was an ex-pimp and you didn't think he was going to get left?
Man, he did a show in Europe called Players
Really,
Ball.
Really, what do you mean I didn't think? No, because he didn't. I wasn't one of his girls. What are you talking about? It'd be different if I was like, what, he had like a stable and I was just a girl? No, I was his lady. There's a difference.
We trying to figure out what's up with the single shit now.
What do you mean?
Pimps.
What about what?
Pimps have a certain mentality, right?
So what are you trying to say? I picked up on some of that? You think
no,
I'm...
No, I'm saying... what I am trying to say, if a dude is actually a pimp, he may go through a phase where he tries to keep a girl, but the pimping is in him. Is he going to go back to it? Don't you think?
Okay, and? So what are you trying to say? He went back to it? Or that...
No.
Shit.
Well, she said he was a pimp.
No, I'm taking his and his... in his whole the background of his word, and I don't think it was literally like you say.
He
like,
was nominated the year that I was up at his house.
No, here's
for
the deal.
For the year.
That's well, that's yeah, that's dude. Silly. That's
that
silly.
No
that's
real
yeah.
Shit.
That's they know him. They know
that's real. I know.
You at the ball.
Real pimps, Mike. Let me tell you, the only real pimps there, the pimps is out of business.
Thank you.
The real pimps is out there on the streets getting that paper, motherfucker. And no goof ass dance.
And anyway, you don't even make real money off that stuff. That's minor.
What?
You don't make a lot of money off pimping.
No, you don't make a lot of money off pimping, but you do get to help your fellow man.
Here we go.
What you do when you help distribute pussy on the street? Men need that shit. I want to let all the women out there who ain't selling pussy know. Pussy is being bought every day. You can miss out if you want to while you're still in your prime.
True, well.
It's a lot of girls who can't sell pussy no more. They can't even get a shit away. While you are able to hustle your pussy, hustle that motherfucker.
Well,
it's
anyway.
A cold world when that motherfucker ball up.
Not as fortunate as you guys to be. Well, are you not? You're not married, are you, Bobby?
No.
Oh, well, Corey is, see. But
a lot of people in the room are saying that you're still in love with Ice. That's why he's still single.
Oh, God, really? That has a lot to do with
yeah,
it.
That might
bless
be
their
true.
Hearts. No, that's what they want to say to believe because they don't want to come at me.
Your top three reasons why you're still single?
And let us say it. Don't interrupt her. Go ahead.
Oh, here, I got to go. Shut your damn ass. You're so loud, Corey. Anyway, the last guy that I was dating, perfect. Now, here we go. Every time I meet someone, there's something wrong. The last guy, and I think you met him, right, Matthew, attorney, 37 years old, perfect. Oh, my God, good looking, smart, just no kids, but he wanted to do the whole marriage and have children. At this point, I'm like, ah, damn it. Everything's all timing. Every time I met somebody, there was something where it just was not going to pan out.
What's wrong with being married and having a kid?
I can't do that no more, Corey. I'm not going to have another child at this age. I don't want to do it anymore.
Are you still able to?
I just said I don't want to do it anymore.
Are
I
you
did
still
that already.
Able to
yeah,
have a child.
Sure, but I don't want to do that.
You still bleed.
Oh my God, Corey, really?
What? I'm
all you have to do is say, are you still able to have children?
Okay,
that's it.
My bad. I thought
yes,
you
I'm still oh my God. I'm still able to have children, but I don't want to do that again because when I did it 100. So I'm exhausted. I would never want to do that again. I did it, thank God.
That's
too,
a nice way to say it. Why couldn't you just tell him that he wasn't worth it for you to go through it?
We both agreed. It's not fair, Corey. He's going to want children. I don't. So
that's
one
a nice
point,
way to say it. Whoever you are and wherever you are.
We're still friends, by the way, because we both agree. We both knew that. That wasn't the reason why we were.
You can go for that bullshit if you want to. Your paper wasn't strong enough to have her go through that bullshit. So get your paper straight, and maybe you can have a family with who you want
to.
Now you got to go pick a substitute, bitch, because the one you wanted wasn't fucking with you like that, because your paper
oh, he's got, believe me, he's got plenty. He's got plenty. He's really good. He's a really good dude. As a matter of fact, all my friends, everybody wants to get with him. He's a real, real good dude.
Your girlfriends want to fuck him?
No, I didn't say sleep with him. I'm saying they want to. He's a good husband.
Gotta
candidate.
Try to clean that bud shit up.
Stop
look,
it.
She getting ready to hit me. I feel it. Oh, she dying late ass motherfucker.
He just moved his big arm and I get it good.
Oh,
no, yay. Anyway, but no, it's just bad timing. It is. I'm serious.
Okay, that's one. Timing's one issue. What's two and three?
You ain't got enough.
Time. Yeah, dude. Children. That whole time that I had my son.
You
now that when he older.
A kid.
That has nothing to do with, that's not that part.
Timing and kids.
Okay, kids, because I had my son, and I don't want to bring no idiots around and have them sleeping over and spending the night and stuff like
what
that.
What up, little shawty?
I didn't do all that, so.
Let's go ahead with your mama and get it on, baby.
Nope, that was not happening.
Come here, baby boy.
And the other one, I don't know. It could be that intimidation, I guess, of the all I know is that I've dated the spectrum of men.
Do you think,
like my favorite, and I don't want to say his name because he lives here in L.A., and the older fellow I was telling you about.
Well, that's nice. Hey, do you think
I adore him. No, that's my buddy, right? We're dating right now, but
I thought you said you were single.
I'm single. That doesn't make it. I don't look.
Girl, is Shadia Lane light skinned?
Do I have
she crazy than a motherfucker?
I am dating. If, do you know that with the word dating?
If she get on the bus, Corey, she will hit a motherfucker.
Corey. Okay, I don't think you've ever. Yeah, dating. Dating.
What
that
is,
means.
Can we explain what is dating?
You're looking for that one. You go out on dates with people. And it's not, I don't want to use the word weed out, but you go out and dates with potential people that you want as your, to me anyway, right now I'm looking for my partner, you know what I'm saying, in crime. Like my, I don't want to say soulmate because I hate using that word, but I want that significant other. I want that special somebody.
That's nice.
It's giving me some collisions out here.
Right, it's a whole bunch. You got to get mad. See? Did you see that? She did the little swing. Women are violent.
And you were slow. I could have really had it. You were slow. But anyway,
you want me to lay off the questions because I have questions that the
no,
callers.
No, I don't mind.
Do Do you think that your fear of commitment will have you...
What is this voice?
Going without...
Without what?
A significant partner in your life?
Probably. And if so, then so be it, because I've had that. Hmm. Where some people never get it, and if they do, it's not going to be for that long time. I got it. I had it. So I've been there. It was nice. If it never happens again in that direction, it's all right. There you go. There you go. Don't you go, Corey. God damn you.
We're having the single Darlene Ortiz now, right here. Darlene, so are there any guys that you wish, besides the obvious Ice-T, are there any guys
there
that
you
wish it would have worked out with?
Afterwards, you mean? Like, or before? Because I was 17 and a half when I met him, Corey.
No, I'm talking about the spectrum of dudes that you have indulged with. Is there any guys out there that you wish it could have worked? Besides, of course.
Matt, the guy I was talking about, Matt the attorney, because that one I really wish. I didn't want to let him go, but I had to because I knew it was going to be, you know, if I strung him along too long, that would have just been wrong because I know he wanted children.
He would have nutted in you?
What, Corey? No.
What? That's how kids come.
No, but you just don't
How did you avoid not having kids?
That's why I broke up with him. Silly, I didn't want to go there with him.
So are you saying, what is his name again?
Matt. I don't want to say his full name.
Are you saying Matt was trying to nut in you? Is that what you're trying to say?
No, Matt asked me, told me I would like to eventually get married and have some children with you. I'm like, oof, that's not going
to
happen.
So are you saying Matt said he wanted to nut in you? That's what we're asking.
However you want to phrase it, Corey, yeah, okay. God.
Matt, she wouldn't allow you to nut in her. That's a major setback as a man, because most women will allow you to nut in them and just deal with it after you nut in them. But she would not allow you to nut in her, so you're going to have to step your game up on the next girl you get.
I don't think he'll have a problem with that, but anyway, so yeah.
Okay, he have a problem, but did he ever nut in you?
Corey, that is none of your business. Okay. Oh my God.
This is stuff that people want to know.
Really? Well, I guess I should ask you some things I want to know then.
Well, people can ask me. They want to put me on the spot. I'm either going to answer or I'm not.
Exactly.
But we wasn't talking about Corey being or wanting to be single or being married or anything. You know what?
Yeah, but who said he was going to bring up all his dirty stuff? Okay, but God, I didn't bring up sex stuff.
Nutting people is part of being around a person. Nobody's going to be around you if you don't have nutting you.
People like you wouldn't be around.
There's a lot of people like me.
Well, then I don't want anything.
Bobby, have you ever been in a girl? I mean, have you? Well, I know you've been in a girl.
Oh, my God.
Fuck Bobby. Oh, poetry.
Stop. There's a caller on the line.
If you had sex with a dude by like five times, he'd have nutted in you. Am I right? She said no.
See? Boo.
Fucking liar. Damn. This shit reversed from the finger in the ass the other week. They ain't gonna tell the truth.
There you go.
Y'all know y'all have stood over the sink and squeezed.
Whatever. Oh, see, the caller dropped. Damn it, Corey. That could have been a...
He gonna call back. God damn it. We talking about nutting and Darlene.
No,
the line
we're not.
Just,
I don't even
I can't believe... Look at all the lines just lit up. Am I right?
Whatever. It's disgusting.
God, people nutting people, god damn it. You wouldn't let the dude who's a lawyer nutting you? Are you out of your fucking...
So, Darlene.
Yes, Bobby.
Do you consider yourself in that group of in your age group unique, or do you represent the body of women in your age group?
Yep, I do. There's a lot of us. There's a gang of us. Because you just get to the point where it's like, you know what? I'm not gonna whine about it. It is what it is. And you just got to keep on trucking on. You got to keep on moving on.
Darlene, like, are unique. Don't even act like you just like another girl walking down the street. It's motherfucker.
Corey, I didn't say that. Did you just listen to what he asked me? Shut up.
There's a whole lot of motherfuckers on there who call their girl. If they knew for sure.
No,
you
know,
who
would
real?
Want somebody
they
like
that?
Hey, bitch, I'm with Darlene, bitch. Bitch.
Gross, but who would want to be with somebody like that left their family to go with you? That speaks about their character, and I don't want that kind of character.
That lets you know to do it on the slide. Don't call your bitch in front of Darlene.
And don't let me know that you are. But the moment I find out, I'm out of there. You can ask anybody. Go on, check the streets. I always tell people this. Go ahead, check my pedigree.
We got a caller.
Go ahead, caller. Sucker.
Ooh.
Go ahead, caller.
Low blow.
I said hey. S. That was S.
Hey, hello? It's late. Come on.
They sleep. They asleep. Hello. There they go.
They trying to click on.
Oh, that's messed up. See,
we got
Corey?
Somebody who said they about to call the Super Sock bitch. These niggas really found her on Twitter.
No, see, now We got a caller, but now you got people harassing her, Corey. Hello, caller, go ahead.
Fuck the bitch, it's Twitter.
Hey.
Say, this is Mike from Tennessee.
All right.
Hey, what up, Mike?
Hey, Darlene, I got to ask you something.
Oh, go ahead, baby.
Darlene, you remind me of something. Okay, I used to date this chick who pretty much is exactly like you. She's a little older. And, you know, since she had a little son, that son was in her teen years. You know what I'm saying? I'm 29. Uh-huh. So, you know, her son was about, 17, 16.
Mm-hmm.
Then she was a little, you know, she was in her 40, you know, mid-40s, something like that. So, I guess she has the same mentality as you have, where she's not trying to start a new life again. Which,
oh, nobody said that. I don't know where you got that.
She ain't want you, dog.
No, I didn't know where. Because I don't know where you got that. I didn't say I didn't want to start my life again. What do you mean? I don't. Is that what he said?
No, hell no.
I want me a dude. Are you kidding me? No. Oh, that. No, who would at that age? That's kind of crazy.
It depends on who you are, dog.
True. But I feel like women like how you are at your age bracket. It's almost like a settling down period where you just want to. You like how things went down in your past, so you're just ready. You're like a seasoned player in the NBA. You're just settled.
Hey, man, who you know team were you on, bro?
Be quiet, Bobby. I kind of hear where he's going with this now. Go ahead, baby. Don't let Bobby interrupt you. My Lord. You done messed up the flow. Damn it, Bobby.
I think he on the pink team.
You know what?
No, I just want to get this right. Sir, you said you had a situation where a girl ain't want to start a family with you, too,
and
right?
Flo boarded his motherfucking ass. That's what happened. That son of a bitch, man. I'm sorry to be the bearer of this bad news, bro. But, you know.
No.
You were seasick and waterbound, bro.
No. Well, Darlene's a good woman. It's just a woman that I dealt with.
Oh.
Man, you need to go back to that shallow.
Let him say what he's going to say.
Stop. I know. Let him. Go ahead, baby.
Brother.
The woman I dealt with, she was a little, you know, she's a little hood ratty. So, you know what I'm saying? I would come over there.
You said she was like Darlene.
No.
See, you guys keep interrupting him, and you're messing with his story. God dang it.
Yeah. No, what I'm saying, like, Darlene has that mentality where, you know, she's just settled. She just wants somebody stable just like her. But with the girl I was dealing with, I'll go over her house, knock her down, you know what I'm saying, set the pussy up, and then go to her son's room and play Madden with him all night. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, my God.
Good shit, you know?
Anyway,
all right, well, thanks, brother. We're going to pray for you. We got another caller. The bitch didn't want you, though. But go ahead. Who next?
So silly.
What's good? It's Jay Nasty.
What up, Jay Nasty, man. My man from St. Louis.
What's good? I'm in Paris Island right now, man. God damn me, Darlene. I'm going to look. I got my nuts snipped about maybe, damn near half a year ago. And I want what you want, baby. Shit.
Is that right?
Hey, I mean, I love the cougar thing.
Oh, well, how old are you?
I'm 27.
Oh God.
Are you in the Army, Jay Nasty?
No, Marine Corps.
He's in the Marine Corps.
Mm. Oh, see, but you're away a lot. See, I done dealt with that already.
My God, the bar is so high here.
No, it's true. There takes a special woman to date people like in the entertainment or in the services and stuff like that. Being real. Seriously, he get him, you know what I'm saying? Get a girl that's going to want to be right there with you on the base or what have you. Or if not, how's that? That's bad.
Why are you sending him away? He said he want what you want.
He don't know. Bless his heart. That's okay, though. You sound so cute.
Well, bless your heart. Tell me.
Honestly, you saw that guy I dated last time, Corey, last year. Remember, he was a 27-year-old, and everybody was making fun of us. I was just having fun. My son kept saying, damn, Mom, my buddies are teasing me, talking about he looked like the homie. Remember homeboy? Jabari.
Dude, age you bumped up a little bit.
He was so cute. Oh, my God.
Saying he was 27. You told me something else before. When we was at the conga room.
He's 27? Yeah, why did you get your stuff snipped? Is that you right there? So
I thought he said he got his nuts sniffed. Did you say
snipped.
You got your nuts
snipped?
Yeah, I had a vasectomy.
Why so early? Do you have children already?
Yeah, I have 3 kids now.
Whoa.
Child's
are they all by the same woman?
Two of them are, but one of them not.
Do you have a little girl?
I mean, you a skeeter.
I have two girls.
Oh, see, I always want a little girl. I'm good. I would have been the best stepmama, but now I'm too tired.
My little girl would be your little girls. You know what I'm talking about?
Oh, but now I'm just exhausted.
That's a good one. That's a good one.
That
I
is
like
cute,
that
though.
One.
That is
my
cute.
My little girls can be your little girls.
I did, though. I always want a little girl. Oh, but you know what? That's you made my night, though, you. I like that, though.
I'm going to make your night, though.
Uh-oh, but I'm going to keep hope alive. I'm going to hang in there, though. But you know what? You made my night. I'm going to go home and sleep good.
Well, you can definitely sleep better after you get some of this Marine Corps dick.
Oh, shit. Look at that.
He came on out the bag on your ass.
That's all right.
This Marine dick.
Even after that, it's good. That's okay, baby. You made my night. I'm serious, right, but I appreciate
you,
that.
Love you, darling.
Oh, love you,
Corey,
too. Handsome self.
Nigga. Be good.
That's what's up,
Bobby,
boy.
Be good, too, bro.
All right, me man. Simplify, man.
All right, man.
Hey, he did have a nice voice, though. Bless his heart. We got another caller. Go ahead, caller. You're on the line.
Hey, you guys. It's Mona from New Orleans.
Hello. Sup, Tree May.
Hello? Uh-oh. Mona.
Did your phone get wet?
Mona.
She's from New Orleans and shit, her phone.
That is messed up. What happened? You know what? Stop it.
That's fucked up. New Orleans, I'm fucking with you. That's it.
Mona.
Katrina came and motherfucking
no.
With all that.
Anyway, that was fun. But you messed with me, Corey, because remember one time you told me about a year ago, you're like, that's right, darling. We're going to have like date Darlene type of thing. And you never did it.
We did it tonight. He broke
you
down.
Brother, in like 20 minutes.
Jay Nasty say he going to hit you
and
with the Marine
late,
dick.
Who's up
and
this
you,
late? The whole world's
even
asleep.
Offended.
Who's up this late?
People
why would be offended? That was kind of cute. That was the last thing. He waited to say that.
Right,
he's
that's
young.
What I'm saying. I met him. He's a nice brother.
He's young. Oh, you know him?
He was at my show in St. Louis.
What? Let me see.
We did that club, the Funny Bone, where them goddamn hillbillies tried that bullshit.
Is
no, he not fat.
But I do like them thick guys, too.
And he tall. Damn, that sounds like I'm describing a nigga. What the fuck? If I was gay, I'd go for tall niggas, I guess.
You're so silly. No, but I'll be all right. Yeah. I'll be all right. And then I gotta also meet some people that meet a guy that loves dogs because I love my baby girl. I love my dog.
Damn, but that's a problem for a man sometimes, you know.
What, getting to know a dog?
No, just having to worry with somebody else's dog.
What's wrong with that? If you love animals, you're not going to have a problem with that, Bobby. You'll be, yeah.
I love women more than I love animals. And sometimes women seem like they get caught up in that, you know, oh, my baby. I'm
well,
like,
they kiss the dog in the face and shit.
Corey, oh, I know you are not complaining about stuff like that. I know you put your mouth in worse places.
I don't kiss my dog in the mouth. I hug
but you
him
should,
and pet him.
Because that's cleaner than everything else.
When he
sniffs
toward my face, I'll be like, get your butt ass out my face.
We got a call. They hung up. See, it's too late. People are falling asleep. Sleep. Anyway,
nobody
we
falling asleep. They got them pussy-ass cricket phones calling this motherfucker. Acting like it's us and shit. Hey,
these low chairs, though, they be digging in my...
You thought you beat the game when your phone plan was $40.
They be digging in my
that
stomach.
That pussy-ass
make
phone.
Make me want to go to the bathroom.
Well, oh.
I be sitting too low. Oh,
we're going to wrap this shit up anyway.
That was fun.
So we talked about the bitch who got stolen predominantly.
Yeah, we did.
And congratulations to the bus driver for not ending up on my casualty report.
Can we get in touch with the bus driver?
What?
My casualty report.
Oh, there you go.
Can we get in touch with the bus driver one day?
I don't know.
He got a commendation coming right from here. from the Real Men's Club. He stepped up.
Man, this girl who gave me that bitch Twitter, Shaddai, the girl who gave me her Twitter, her name is Leslie, the CEO. And she got this thing on her shit from Instagram. It say, swag is for boys, class is for men.
Class mean you supposed to let a bitch pimp slap you and that makes you a class man. Is that what she's suggesting?
No. She said, like, you know, swag is like a lot of stuff.
Yeah, they
like,
use that,
I
yeah.
got swag. You know, it's the new thing to say.
Oh.
Nigga with his pants hanging off his
yeah.
ass.
Oh, that's swag?
About he got swag.
Really?
Swag to them.
We can get that fag, motherfucker.
That's what I was getting substitute.
The fuck away from me and my family.
Oh, you would like that other video that Rebecca has in, too, about that.
Hey, so we...
Bastard. Anyway, no, that was fun. I was a little bit more awake tonight, though. That's for sure.
That's good. So this is the bootleg version of the 5150 show here on RMC. The number to call in next week is 323-965-1600. I'm Corey Holcomb.
I'm Darlene. OG Ortiz on Twitter.
This is Bobby Glanton Smith.
And I want to let you know that your daddy ain't living with y'all because your mama was a bitch. All right, later.